aside recently reported missing seized excavators, there was an undercover expose conducted by Anas Amia Anas and Joy News, many of which stories have raised questions about the direction of the campaign and the commitment of officials, especially politicians, to the success of the campaign. This should be a cause for us all politicians to worry, especially when in September 2012, a University of Ghana Business School policy brief by Benjamin A. Teacher predicted in its summary of key findings that the inherently political nature of the Galamsey menace in Ghana suggests that any anti-Galamsey crusade that fails to tackle the political drivers of the problem is unlikely to succeed. Quote and unquote. Mr. Speaker, as leaders of the nation, never before has it become imperative, at least in the face of these reports of murky political associations and conspiracies, for us to act to assure all citizens that their resources, confidence, and support when reports in us will not be in vain. His Excellency the President, who boldly put his presidency on the line to demonstrate how much this cause meant to him, if for nothing at all, Mr. Speaker, has his presidency to say. And it will be important that he starts by accounting for, and to the people of Ghana, all equipment, vehicles, weapons, ammunition, and gold, which were seized and kept by officers he commissioned to help end illegal mining, and if necessary, penalize all who are proven to have been negligent or complicit in what may have gone wrong.